The Philippines reports 3,972 new COVID-19 cases today. This is the first time in more than 2 months that new cases registered below 4,000. The total now stands at 1,188,000. The country's COVID-19 death toll has crossed the 20,000 mark after 36 new deaths were recorded. 4,600 new recoveries also reported. This does not include data from 10 laboratories.
An urgent call from the World Health Organization as several countries deal with a resurgence of COVID-19 cases. It wants at least 10% of the population of every country vaccinated by the end of September. Over 100 countries have received 72 million doses through COVAX so far. But the WHO admits those doses are insufficient.
So today, I'm calling on member states to support a massive push to vaccinate at least 10% of the population of every country by September, and a drive to December to achieve our goal of vaccinating at least 30% by the end of the year. This is crucial to stop severe disease and death, keep our health workers safe, reopen our societies and economies.
Coronavirus cases all over the world have reached 167 million. The death toll, meanwhile, is now at 3.4 million.
Here in the Philippines, the total number of COVID-19 vaccine doses administered has surpassed 4.3 million. Testing Chief Vince Dison also says vaccinations per day are now averaging 166,000. He admits this is still not sufficient, saying the goal is to vaccinate some 500,000 people per day. But Dizon is optimistic that target is achievable with more vaccines arriving in the country in the coming weeks. Inoculations are underway for the first three groups of the vaccination priority list, composed of health workers, the elderly, and people with comorbidities. Malacanang maintains senior citizens and people with health risks who refuse to take available vaccines will be moved back to the end of the line and lose their priority slot in the inoculation drive.
Ang binigyan lang po natin na pagkakataon na mamili ang mga health frontliners natin. Lahat po ng mamamayan, pwede ko kayong turukan ng bakunang available. At kung mamimili po tayo, well, pwede naman po, kaya lang magantay tayo sa hulihan. Sana po eh hindi kayo maunahan ng mas nakakahawang mga mutants ng coronavirus habang nag-iintay ng gusto ninyong brand.
The president of the League of Provinces of the Philippines admits the rollout of COVID-19 vaccines outside Metro Manila has been slow-going. Presbyterio Velasco Jr., who is also the governor of Marinduque, says some provinces have not even finished inoculating 30% of their senior citizen population. But with the bulk of the country's supply of jabs set to arrive in the third quarter, Velasco says local government units need to be prepared to administer them quickly.
Much now depends on the capacity and efficiency of the vaccination teams of each local government unit. The DOH considers that the allocation of the vaccines rely a lot on that efficiency of the teams because the vaccines may also be spoiled.
Start with the willing. That's a call of Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatallan, as vaccine hesitancy remains high among members of government's priority groups. He says government should start vaccinating the general population as early as June. He believes this can be done in Metro Manila, with the Philippines set to receive around 20 million vaccine doses next month.
To achieve herd immunity by end of the year, you have to start with the willing. The most important is to allay the fears. No? If you look at the SWS survey, the number one there is fear that it might cause injury to themselves. Uh-oh. The fear of the unknown. My simple strategy for that is for the leaders to come out and promote vaccination.
Gatallan also backs government's plan to vaccinate teenagers with Pfizer.
Looking at the trends in the U.S., that they already started vaccinating teenagers. And this is a good sign because, again, no, parents are very emotional when it comes to face-to-face classes. and allocating vaccines for our teenagers will build that confidence up. As to when, I still believe that we allow first the adults because the adults are susceptible, and when we vaccinate them, they can go back to work. Then after the adults, we can now move into the teenagers. My analysis here is let the school year end. It will end by this July. Hopefully by come August, September, for the new school year, we'll have a better situation. We'll have more people vaccinated. The most important is get our teachers vaccinated. And this is a sign of confidence among in the education sector.
The Philippines aims to vaccinate at least 50 million of its population by year end to achieve herd immunity.